Hi everyone, it's Matt. Now everyone can tell you how to properly power a 100 watt LED. You will need some sort of voltage controller, or better still, a constant current controller. These solutions are pretty straightforward. You just need to connect your power supply, your load, and you need to calibrate this little variable resistor. In this case, we have just one. This control the output voltage. In this case, we have two, which will allow us to control the maximum and the minimal current, which will flow from the input to the output. This is really straightforward, but I will ask you this. How can you automate this process? You will need to manually regulate this potentiometer. You can put this one in series to a bigger one, which you can operate by hand, but even still, you will need to operate by hand. But I want to completely automate this process. How can we solve this problem? Well, there is an easy way and there is an hard way. I've picked the easy way. Today, I will show you how to use a simple and cheap stepper motor in order to operate this potentiometer. Let's see how. Alright, so this is the base onto which we are gonna mount the step-down converter and the other bracket which will hold the stepper motor. Now, this is just a prototype in order to see if the whole system is viable. It's not meant to be a definitive solution to our project. It's just a base onto which we are gonna put all of our code. It's a simple print, it's gonna take about 1 hour. This is the bracket which will hold the stepper motor, which will go here, pointing obviously downwards, while these holes will hold the stepper motor control board, which we will mount up here. And these holes will go onto the platform, which we've just seen. This is maybe the most precise component, which will connect the stepper motor, which will go in here, to the potentiometer, which will go in here. As you can see, this is a cone. In this way, the potentiometer screws will fit onto this wall, and we will have traction when we need to rotate it. Alright, so the core of the vault is a 100 watts step-down converter. This converter can take voltages from 4.5 up to 30 volts and step it down up to the input voltage. It is advisable to use an higher than 12 volts power supply because many of those under load cannot actually reach 12 volts, which is the nominal voltage for running LED lights. We will also need a 10 volts line. For this line, I will use an LM2596 DC-to-DC converter, and this line will be used to power both the Arduino and the stepper motor. This will need a calibration. The first time we set this up, we will need to calibrate the potentiometer in order to output a voltage from 9 to 12 volts. So our Arduino will be put to ground and the V-in pin will be connected to our 10 volts line. We will need to read both the input and the output voltage. The input voltage will be needed only to be compared to the voltage that we requested. If we request a voltage above the input voltage, we will prompt an error because this is a step-down converter. It cannot go higher than the input voltage. Now the voltage can go up to 30 volts, so we will need a voltage divider because the analog pin into the Arduino can read only up to 5 volts. So if we use a voltage divider from 400 ohms and 2.2 kilo ohms, we will be able to measure up to 30 volts. The output line will depend on our application. In my case, I want to drive an LED light, so a range from, let's say, 9 to 12 volts is ideal. I've used the same resistor and the input line because the first time
we turn this on, the output voltage could be equal to the input voltage. So if you use a voltage divider calibrated to read maximum 12 volts, we will fry the Arduino. In order to turn the step down module potentiometer, I will use a stepper motor. This can be very cheap and can be bought with their controlling board for like $2 on AliExpress. The control board is often included and it is essential in order to run the stepper motor. We'll connect the 5-pin ribbon cable of the stepper to this board, and then we will connect the power ground to ground and the input voltage to the 10 volts line. We need then to connect the 4 coil pin to the Arduino. In my example, I pick digital pins from the 8 up to the 11, and this will be used in order to activate at different time the different coil in order to generate a rotation. And this is actually it. Alright, so here we have the sketch. It's really actually simple. I based my code upon this project. You can check it out, it's pretty interesting. The pinout is as following. The stepper motor is connected from digital pin 8 through digital pin 11, while the analog pin A0 is there for the inline, and the A1 is for the outline. Here we define the two resistors, which will allow us to read voltages up to 30 volts thanks to the voltage divider we set up. R2 is 400 ohms, while R1 is 2.2 kilo ohms. In the setup, we set up the stepper motor and we read the voltage. The in voltage will be read only once, only here, while their out voltage will be read also into the loop, obviously. Alright, here we are in the loop. This part is pretty important. Every 1000 cycles we will read the serial monitor if we have an input. If we have an input, we will store that input into the VREQ voltage request variable. We will then read the output voltage and set up the direction of the stepper motor. True or false, if the voltage is below the voltage request, the direction will be true. True means counterclockwise. On the other hand, if our output voltage is above the voltage request, the direction will be set to false, which means clockwise. This tolerance is very important. Without it, you will never reach the equilibrium. You will keep going past the voltage request and going back, and so on and so forth. I've set this tolerance here, 0.4 volts. You can lower this, but you will need most likely to tweak this 1000. You will need to lower this. Now, you cannot read the serial monitor and the voltage output every cycle, because if you do so, the stepper motor won't work properly. You will need to set this if with at least 500. With 1000 everything was fine, and the tolerance of 0.4 volts is more than enough for my intentions. Every 1000th cycles we do this, while every cycles we move the stepper if the voltage is outside our equilibrium zone. If we are outside the equilibrium zone, we will move the stepper step by step from step 0 to step 7. We will then update the step depending if our direction is true or false. If it is true, the stepper count will go up. Otherwise, if our direction is set to false, it will go down from 7 to 0, while here from 0 to 7. If we are inside the equilibrium zone, on the other hand, we will simply stop the stepper with this function, which will set all the 4 pin to low.
So we will just plug in our 12 volts power supply and our USB.
All right. We'll flash the sketch and we will launch the serial monitor. Alright, here we can see the output voltage, which is about 10 volts, which is the standard setup here, VREC equal 10. I can input in the serial monitor the voltage that I want. So if I type 7 volts, for example, our stepper motor will turn counterclockwise until we are at 7 volts, considering the tolerance of 0.4 volts which we've set here. So if I want to go up to 11 volts, I just set this up and the motor will turn until I've reached the requested voltage. As you can see, at the lower voltages the transition is not super smooth, but it's good enough for my application.
So there you have it, a simple way for controlling a big load. Clearly this is not a big load, but this step down converter can handle up to 100 watts, so this big ass LED can be easily controlled using the same idea. As you can see, you can program your Arduino to do whatever you want with your load. For instance, in this case I've put a cycle between a minimum voltage of 7 volts and a maximum voltage of 11 volts, and it go back and forth between those two. You can do whatever you like. I didn't finalize this project, as you can clearly see, we are still on the breadboard, because this is just the first part of a bigger project. Next time we will see how to control this setup using an ASP8266, so controlling this system via a web page. That should be interesting. Stay tuned, and the FTBA.